أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي I hope you all sisters are doing well bismillah Today we will be doing Surah An-Naba Juz 30 Surah number 78 Ayat number 7 and 8 These two ayats are actually connected and that is why we have done them together and they are actually very short ayats each having only two words that is why we'll be doing it together inshallah okay starting with the ayat number 7 wal jibala now this is a combination of four words let us start with the very first word wa the vowel with the fatha is wa wa is basically a harfe ataf which means a coordinating conjunction as we all know a conjunction will help in joining two sentences so this is again connected to the previous sentence and it is translated as and so and is the first word the second word al jibala as we know starts with al and again al is a definite article the al makes any noun specific so al is the then we come to the next word jibala Now, jibala comes from the root word jabala, which means mountain, hill. Okay. Now, jabala is actually in singular form jabalu and in plural jibal. So, over here, the jibal basically means mountains. So, together now we have wa and al the jibala. Mountains and the mountains the next word is autada now autada is again a noun okay now over here the root words are vatada okay so together it means autad now autad means pegs stakes woolworks whenever we are making a tent we need pegs to hold it on okay so it makes the tent stand these pegs are called autad okay here allah subhanahu wa taala made the mountains as pegs like the mountains that you see they actually are controlling the activities of the earth okay if there are any tectonic activities that take place the mountains control these okay so just like the tent is tied down the earth is tied down using these pegs even if I take the example of a paperweight so the moment that paperweight is kept on a paper the paper will not be able to do much it cannot fly out so the same way allah has made the mountains like pegs which are holding on the earth okay now we come to the next verse okay before that let us just revise the seventh verse again so wa was and al jibala was the mountains and pegs together the sentence becomes and the mountains as pegs okay so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the mountains as pegs. Now we come to the next verse, ayat number 8. Wa khalaqnakum. Over here, we are starting with wa, which I just explained in the earlier sentence also, the earlier verse, that this is a harfe ataf, which means a coordinating junction. So, again, it is and. Okay. The next is khalaqa. Khalaq. Khalaqa is a verb okay over here khalaqa it comes from the root word khalaqa which means creation or something related to creating. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and created. Let us stop here, because who created? So the next word tells us that the na, the noon with a standing fatah, which means na. So far you'll have learnt the na that comes in the end of a sentence. So we know the na signifies plural. It comes in three forms. The na that comes in the beginning of a sentence, beginning of a word, like we did in the earlier Naj Ali. Okay. So over there, the Naj Ali started with the na, which signified we. Over here, it's in the center as na, and sometimes it comes in the end as na. Okay, so these are the three forms in which the plural is signified, we. So, and khalaq, we khalaqa created na, we created kum. The kum is an attached pronoun. Okay, as we have seen, it is attached to the verb khalaqa, created you. Okay, now kum actually signifies plural masculine. Well, it is a concluded fact that whenever a plural is masculine, it includes the feminine also. So, as a matter of fact, when we are talking about the next word, I will explain this kum as why is it plural and both male and female. Okay, so the other word is azwaja. Azwajan or azwaja, the root word is zawaja, which means zauj. Zauj means a couple, a pair. Okay, so azwaja is actually the plural form of the verb, of the noun zauj. Okay, zauja. So the plural is azwaja, so in pairs. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling that we created you, meaning in sounds masculine but has the feminine. That is why we created you in pairs. So altogether the whole sentence becomes we created you in pairs. So again, I'll just repeat both the sentences, both the verses. And the mountains as pegs, and we created you in pairs. So over here we are done with verse 7 and 8. Inshallah ta'ala, we will continue tomorrow. Jazakallahu khairan kaseeran kazeera. Subhanaka allahumma wa bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.